Hello students, so let us start with the notch filter, that is image distortion chapter number 6 of digital image processing. The notch filter we already checked in the last presentation. The notch filter rejects or passes the frequencies in predefined neighborhoods about the center frequency, and due to the symmetry of the Fourier transform, notch filter must appear in symmetric pairs about the origin. So this is the ideal notch filter, this is the Butterworth notch filter, and this is the Gaussian notch filter, and its responses are like this. Next, where the d1 and d2 is under root u minus m divided by 2 minus u bracket square plus v minus n divided by 2 minus v0, and the d2 will be under root of u minus m divided by 2 plus v bracket square and plus v minus n divided by 2 plus v bracket square. The Butterworth notch filter, the formula is like this, and Gaussian notch filter, the formula is like this. This filter becomes high pass rather than the suppress. These filters are act as a high pass rather than the suppress. The frequencies contained in the notch areas suppress the frequencies. This filter will perform exactly a portion function to the notch reject filter. The transfer function of this filter may be given as a 1 minus nr h of nr uv. That is, h of np is nothing but the passband filter and h of nr is nothing but the notch reject filter. These are the some examples of the notch filter where d0 is taken as a 16. Next one, optimum notch filtering. The image is derived from the electro-optical scanners, such as those used in the space and aerial imaging, are sometimes corrupted by the coupling and the amplifier of low-level signals in the scanner circuitry. The resulting images tend to contain substantial periodic noise. So, it contains the periodic noise. The interference patterns are, however, in practice not always as clearly defined in the sample shown thus far. The first steps in optimum notch filtering is the n of uv is equal to h of uv into g of uv. G of uv is the Fourier transform of the corrupted images, and the eta of xy, that is the noise, is the Fourier transform of this same function. So as the corrupted image g of x assumed to be formed by the addition of uncorrupted image, that is f of xy plus noise, interference noise. So if the noise terms eta of xy were completely known, the subtracting the same it from the g of xy, so you will get the f of xy. So these are the some examples. Estimating the degradation function. So up till now we are estimated the noise function by the different filter, that is band pass and band reject filter, notch filter, optimum filter. Now if we estimate the degradation function, what will be the effect of on the image distortion? So this slides explains about how far we concentrate mainly at the additive noise term, that is eta of xy. So up till now we are concentrated on the term of eta of xy, that is a noise term. After that we are going to concentrate on the ways to remove the degradation function, that is a degradation function h, right? So this is the block diagram of the degradation model. So we already studied this block diagram before starting at the start of this presentation. So f of xy, your original function, it is applied to the degradation function, and the eta of xy is the noise it is added with. After the addition you will get the signal g of xy, and it is applied to the restoration filter, where restoration filter out your image. F cap of xy, we should be or expected that f cap of xy should be equal to or same shape of f of xy, but it depends upon the noise and degradation function. So how we remove the additive noise, we already checked with the different filter or study with the different filter. Now we are going to concentrate on the degradation function or estimation of the degradation function. So the estimating the degradation function, there are three principal methods to estimate the h, that is degradation function. That is first one, observation, that is experimenting with the observation, experimentation, different experimentation, and mathematical modeling. The process of restoring a corrupted image using the estimated degradation function is sometimes called the blind convolution. That is corrupted, restoring the corrupted image by using the estimated degradation. So it is called as a blind convolution, as true degradation is seldom completely known. So degradation function is completely known. In the recent year, the fourth method based on the maximum likelihood estimation, that is MLE, maximum likelihood estimation, is called as a blind convolution. So MLE is also called as a blind convolution. So the first one is the by observation, that is the estimation function. By the observation. So if the given data is like this, a degraded image without any information about the degradation function H. So solution is like this. Solution have the four steps, that is the solution, that is select sub image with the strong signal content G of XY. By estimating, the second step is by estimating the sample gray levels of the object and background in the G of XY. So gray level samples, so we have to estimate the gray level samples and its background of the G of XY image. We construct the unblurred image, that is the construction of the unblurred image of the same size and characterized as the observed sub image F cap of XY. So assuming that the effect of the noise is negligible, so transfer function will be H of UV is equal to G of UV divided by F cap of UV. That is, thanks to shift invariance, we deduce the H of UV, that is deducing the estimation function, degradation function H of UV from HS of UV. So this is the estimating the function by image observation. Next, second ways to estimate the function, that is the estimating the degradation function, is the estimating by the experimentation. The given data is equipment similar to the equipment used to acquire the degraded image, and the solution is like this. The image is similar to the degraded image and can be acquired with the various setting until it closely matches to the degraded image. So the system can be characterized by measuring the impulse, that is the bright dot of the light, and a linear shift invariant system can be fully described by its impulse response. So Fourier transform of impulse will be G of UV divided by A. So G of UV is the Fourier transform of the observed image, and A is the constant describing the strength of the impulse. So in this way, we can estimate the degradation function by experimenting. So next one is the estimating the degradation function by the mathematical modeling. The degradation mathematical modeling has been used for the many years. However, it requires in-depth understanding of the involved physical phenomenon. In some cases, it can be even incorporate environmental condition that causes the degradation. So, it can be indicated as H of UV is equal to E raised to K into U square plus V square raised to 5 by 6, where K is the constant that depends upon the nature of turbulences. Expect 5 by x power above the equation has the same function as a Gaussian low-pass filter. So these are the example of the turbulence model. Next one is the inverse filtering. There are two types, inverse, that is direct and indirect. The direct inverse filtering, the simplest approach to restore a degraded image is to form the estimate of the form F cap of UV is equal to G of UV divided by H of UV, and then obtain the corresponding image by inverse Fourier transform. So inverse Fourier transform, we can obtain the corresponding image. This method is called as a direct inverse filtering. With the degradation model equation, we get so F cap of UV, which is your degraded output image, is equal to F of UV plus N of UV divided by H of UV. So this simplest equation tells us that even if we know the H of UV, that is the degraded function, exactly could not recover the undegraded image F of XY completely, because the noise component is the random function. whose Fourier transform is not known. So this is the first reason. And second reason is, in practice, h of uv, that is a Degaard's function, can contain numerous zeros. The direct inverse filtering is seldom a suitable approach in the practical application. Next, we have two practical approaches for inverse filtering. One is the low-pass filtering and constraint division. Low-pass filtering is done by f cap of uv is equal to g of uv divided by h of uv into l of uv, where l of uv is the low-pass filter that estimate the should eliminate very low values often experienced in the high frequencies. Contrast division, it is g of uv divided by h of uv for modulus of h of uv is greater than or equal to t, and when this function is g of uv when the modulus of h of uv is less than d, and gives the value of h of uv is lower than the threshold d. D is the threshold, a special treatment. This approach is also called as a pseudo inverse filtering. So this approach is constraint division approach is called as a pseudo inverse filtering. So these are the examples. Artificial inverse filtering, it is tempting from its simplicity, that the direct inverse filtering approach does not work for the practical application, even if the Degaardian function is exactly known. So we can use the artificial inverse filtering. Next, linear filtering. this is the improvement in the inverse filtering. This filter seeks an estimate that maximum statistical error function f cap of f, that is e square is equal to e of, that is energy function of f minus f cap bracket square, where e is the expected value, f is the undegarded image, and the solution of this equation is like this. H of uv is Degaardian function, modulus of h of uv bracket square is nothing but the h that is complex h of uv into real h of uv, that is a complex h of uv is the complex conjugate of h, s is the power spectrum, and sf is the power spectrum of undegarded image. Geometric mean filter. The geometric mean filter is generalization of the inverse filtering and Wiener filtering, though its parameter alpha beta allows access to entire family of the filter. So it can be given like this, where alpha is equal to 1, so it may be the inverse filtering, alpha is equal to 1 by 2 and beta is equal to 1, the spectrum equalization filtering, and if alpha is equal to 0, the parametric Wiener filter where beta is equal to 1. Next, constraint least square, that is a regularized filter. The constraint least square filtering approach only requires the knowledge of mean and variance of the noise. So for this filter, there should be the mean and variance of the noise is already known parameter for the distortion. As shown in the previous lecture, these parameters can be usually estimated from the Degaard image. The definition of the 2D convolution is nothing but this. And using this equation, we can express the linear convolution model, so, and which is given by g of xy is equal to h of xy into f of xy plus your noise parameter eta of xy, where g is equal to hf plus eta, that is h is the Degaardian function into f plus eta noise. Constraint least squares filtering. So it is obvious that the distortion problem is now reduced to the simple matrix manipulation also, and this problem with the matrix manipulation is that H matrix is very large when Mn into Mn and its inverse is firstly very sensitive to the noise and secondly does not necessarily exist. So the its Laplacian is equal to C is equal to summation of x is equal to 0 to n minus 1, y is equal to 0 to n minus 1, deviation square f of xy. F of xy is your image and its deviation, and it is subjected to the gamma function. that is h cap of uv is equal to h, that is complex conjugate of uv divided by the h of, that is constraint modulus of constraint function plus gamma function, where the gamma is the parameter and it should be must adjusted so that the constraint satisfy the p of uv, and p of uv is the Fourier transform of the Laplace operator, so it can be padded with the different zeros. Optimal selection of the gamma, so gamma can be adjusted with by using this formula. Is the optimal selection given the above optimization equation sigma n and m of eta are mean and variance of the noise, and it is very important to understand that the optimum restoration is the sense of constraint least squares, does not necessarily to imply the best visual sense. In general, automatic determined restoration filters yield the inferior results to manual adjustment of the filter parameters. So this is about the image distortion with using the filters. Thank you.